Now that we know what the electromagnetic voltage is, we also can find the current. We know that the current, which we would be measuring here with our current meter, the current is equal to VEMF times the resistance like this. V is equal to IR. So whatever resistance we've got across this, we can find both the current and the VEMF. There's one other useful thing here, and that's to recognize that the VEMF is given by the contour integral of the electric field over the closed contour of the loop. This C is the loop contour. Now, putting this all together gives us Faraday's law, and we can see that the closed contour of the electric field, DL, which is equal to VEMF, is equal to minus the integral of dB by dt dotted with ds. Now this is the integral form of Faraday's law. If we would like the differential form of Faraday's law, we're just going to apply Stokes' theorem, which says that we can integrate Stokes' theorem says that the integral over a closed contour is equal to the integral over a surface of the curl of that same vector. And then, since we can see that we've got an integral over a surface on both the left and right-hand side, we can come up with the integral form, which just says the curl of the electric field is equal to minus the time derivative of the magnetic flux density. So let's talk about the two different ways of applying Faraday's law. This one right here is very commonly used. Suppose that you have a loop, maybe a circular loop, that has a magnetic field that's going through it, and you're given some equation like B is equal to some magnitude times the cosine of omega t, and let's suppose that it's in the z direction. That means that phi is going around this way, and z is coming out of the board. We can see that we have a time variation because we have a cosine in our b term, and the radius of the loop, let's suppose that is staying the same. We need to know how many turns of the loop we have. I don't know, perhaps 15 turns of the loop. And in this case, we could find the VEMF at two terminals right here. It would simply be minus n, which is 15, times the integral over this surface of the derivative with respect to time of the B field dotted with ds. Now our ds here is going to be in the z direction. That's going to be r dr d phi. Phi is going to go from 0 to 2 pi, and r is going to go from 0 to a. The time derivative is going to give us minus 15 times 10 times omega times the sine of omega t. These are going to dot to 1. The r term is simply going to integrate to r squared over 2, and the phi term is going to integrate to phi from 0 to 2 pi. And this is going to tell us the EMF voltage at the terminals of this loop. If we wanted to know the current in the loop, we would take VEMF and we would divide it by r. So I is going to be VEMF divided by the resistance of the loop. If we wanted to find the electric field, what we would do is integrate around this contour like so. Oops, I'm going the wrong direction here. Integrate it around like that. So my contour integral of E dot dl is going to be E phi in the phi direction dotted with my phi directed dl, which is R d phi, and we need to integrate that as phi goes from 0 to 2 pi. R in this case is the radius of the loop A. So we're going to get A times E phi times phi from 0 to 2 pi, and these dot to 1. So we're going to have 2 pi A times E phi. So if we wanted to find E phi, we would be able to do it by just equating these terms.